You've certainly been keeping me busy. However, it's nice to have something to focus on. Sending the dead on their journey may seem like a depressing task, but it gives me a sense of purpose. Another astounding victory. I am impressed by your courage and vigor, fledgling. Once again, I reiterate, I have been stuck here for such a long time and accomplished so little in comparison to you. You have given this old crow hope for the first time in many, many years. Just one more giant soul and we can open death's door. I suggest you head west. Atop the mountain, you will meet an ancient beast of untold years. You found some incense. This stuff smells very strong. An incense used in ancient rituals to aid the dead in their passage to the next life, and to mask the stench of corpses in the embalming process. The label on the side reads, "Incense of Atonement, perfect for masking that rotting corpse smell." Hello again, Beakface. How goes your adventure? I like to stop by the Stranded Sailor to refresh my stock of Jefferson's delicious soup. He's an odd fellow, but a great chef. You found an adventure journal. It is very damp. The pages seem to be stuck together. This waterlogged old journal's early chapters describe a tale of being sucked through a giant door under the sea and having to start a new life stranded atop a mountain. The later chapters just talk a lot about the writer's friendship with a squid. You received the Grunt's old mask. It seems this Grunt is loyal to a new leader now. This mask is carved to resemble the Frog King. Many of the Grunts that inhabit this land are feeble of mind, desiring a leader to give them purpose. They often show loyalty by making and wearing a mask in their image. Such is the unwavering bond between Grunt and leader that it almost resembles a cult. Hello again, little bird. Me come far and wide, see many thing. World outside, very beautiful. Love, laugh, live. That all Grunt want. Good for you. Oh, Betty, my beautiful Betty. Greetings, fellow biped. My name is Jefferson, a humble bartender and seafood enthusiast at your service. Could these human hands prepare you a delicious meal today? Great. One delicious meal coming right up. I sure do love preparing food with my multi-digited mammal hands. Now let me tell you a little something while you ingest nutrients. There's a sewer not far from here that might lead to treasure. Although if there's no treasure in there, don't blame me. It's a sewer after all. Perhaps once you have explored some more, I will also have knowledge with which to nourish your mind. That's all I have for you for now. This way to the mountaintops, via Castle Lockstone. Well, hello there, fellow traveler. Go on, tell all. How's your adventure going? Got any exciting tales I could knock out a song about? Reason being, I'm up in these here mountains seeking inspiration for my next masterpiece. I heard a monster lives up in the mountaintops. Can you believe it? That drunk fella outside the stranded sailor says he lost his love to the beast. Fancy that. The way I see it, there's gotta be one heck of an epic ballad awaiting me up ahead. If only I could smash up these blasted rocks blocking the path. Look at that, mate. You smashed it. You're a legend. You might even be the inspiration for my next big tune. Yeah. If it's all the same to you, I might just tag along on your adventure. See you around. Castle Lockstone, the Frozen Fortress. Hey again, pal. I hope you don't mind me tagging along. Seems like we'll need to find a way through this old fortress if we want to get up that mountain. Well, I say we, I mean you. I'll just hang around here and work on the lyrics for my next banging tune. Let me know if you find a way up. Two. It's so cold. Here lies Lord Lockstone, the first Lord of Doors to make a deal with death. Their legacy is inestimable and their reign absolute. A cold ruler concerned with law and order, who consolidated power and would go on to build the foundations of the Hall of Doors. This is the resting place of we, the Lords of Doors. I am Lord Lockstone, for whom this crypt was named. We Lords of Doors were an anomaly, a mistake of the universe, I might say. But is that not an apt description of all life? A mistake of the universe, one which grows and thrives. Existence born into consciousness. And to preserve that consciousness is the most important and noble goal. Entombed alongside the old lords. I suppose some would call it an honor. I would call it a tragedy. Here lies Lord Theodore, the first successor in the lineage of lords. Their transition to power was smooth and their reign egalitarian, remembered for their fair nature enforcing better working conditions for reapers. My life is ending, but this lord plans to live forever. It doesn't feel fair to me. You found an ancient crown. It feels unusual to the touch, as if it once contained life. an ancient crown worn by the first Lord of Doors. The Lords are beings of pure soul energy, only able to hold corporeal form thanks to their armor binding their soul to this world. Made from a metallic yet organic material, each descendant has its armor forged by the preceding Lord. However, the creation of the first Lord remains a mystery. Posted in this fortress, I have learned a great deal about the old Lords of Doors. Still don't much care for them. Be careful, living Reaper. A gift to a fellow crow to aid you on your quest. Hookshot spell acquired. The removal of the legacy doors has seriously impeded my investigation into the disappearance of the Reapers in the redacted region. This whole process of transferring to the new system has been a nightmare. I have found evidence that many workers were active in the region when the orders were given to cut them off. More worrying still is that the active reaping mission in the area was also purged from the system. Somewhere out there is a soul that has not been reaped on time. It's a recipe for disaster, that's for sure. We all know what happens to souls if they remain alive past their death date. That Vaga reckons that something big is going to happen here soon. You know anything about that, buddy? I don't know why anyone was complaining. These things are adorable. And they like the same TV shows as me. I'm just relaxing, feeding the birds. But none of my friends want to eat off the floor. You found a scale model of a Reaper door. It doesn't function and was probably made to evaluate the designs for the modern doors that Reapers use today. This scale model of a door has a note attached. They're slimmer, easier to use, and more reliable. They no longer process raw souls like the legacy design. We will be introducing a vault which processes souls for the power grid that the new doors run on. Everything will be automated by the Commission. Even minor souls used for purchases will be fed back into the system. I'm done with this job. I found the notes from the investigator looking into the events around the disappearance of Reapers, and the closures of all those active doors. This Lord of Doors doesn't give two shinies about any of us crows. What is it all for? Myself and a few of the other Reapers I've convinced to join me are heading into the Forbidden Region to see what we can find. I hope we can start a new life without the Commission. A new challenge awaits us. These creatures are so colorful. They're giving me a migraine. And they're coming through the doors that you left open. Honestly, you're turning my office into a dimensional Swiss cheese. I'll save for that. My little friend got into my ink supply, the poor dear. Although she doesn't seem to mind. Maybe she just loves the smell of ink as much as I do. Ink, ink, lets out a stink. But I love it so much I could practically drink it. You're back. Here lies Lord Opengate, the third in the lineage of lords. Their rule was steady and without hindrance. A ruler skilled at delegation, they spent many of their years expanding their knowledge while traveling the vastness of space. Greetings, young Reaper. Your presence here is quite a conundrum. It would indicate that the course of events which started with the formation of Death's Door has led the universe to the brink of a great peril. However, it is also indicative of those actions correcting themselves. Life is merely the universe experiencing itself. And, as the universe seeks balance in all things, we, as part of it, are all acting to maintain that balance. Stay true to your path, young Reaper. I can sense victory in your future. Thank you. Sweet child, look at what has happened to your life at the hands of our chaos. I was never sold on the idea of preserving the course of life and death. Each lord creates the next in succession before their death, and teaches them the lord's path. My creator, the lord before me, bound me to their system. All I could do was try and balance the world as fairly as I could. I tried my best to do right by the living, especially the crows, recruited into something they had no business in. If opportunity presents itself, child, ending the cycle would be what is right for the universe. My lifetime was too short to come to that ultimate conclusion, but I remain hopeful that others will reach it on their own. Here lies Lord Deadbolt, the fourth in the lineage of Door Lords. Their rule was dark but produced efficiency among Reapers. An overbearing ruler concerned with keeping order and funding research into sustainable forms of life extension. My life was not easy. The balance of the universe was my duty and mine alone. The Lord who created me had grand illusions about fate and purpose. But fate did not bind me to death's door. Duty did. No other could take on the task of controlling life and death, so I bore the burden. I bore it for as long as I could, even extending my life beyond the bounds set by the pitiful anachronism that is death. When my life finally drew to a close, my successor paid no heed to my teachings. I fear their reign may have destroyed the balance I tried so hard to maintain. What a bitter disappointment they have been. Greatness is seldom free, Crow. True greatness may even cost you your soul. You found some kind of signed contract. How exciting. This appears to be some kind of contract. It resonates with an uncanny energy. It has been written in an ancient text you can't read. Hey, you got the old elevator working. Perfect timing, too. I just finished the next chapter of my song. You'll be wanting to hear it, I imagine. Alright, here we go. I'll tell you a tale as old as time. A classic repeating paradigm. A maiden trapped at the peak of our climb. Her fisherman love driven out of his mind. The hero will right the wrongs of this crime. This way to our camp. See you soon. Welcome to the camp of the Free Crows, old friend. We knew you'd make it here eventually. Even if you needed a bit of guidance along the way. We are a group of free-thinking individuals who reject the ideas of the Lord of Doors. We do not want unnatural immortality if it must come at the cost of our lives. What is the point in living forever if it's to be as a slave? No, we choose to live free and die free. So go, climb ever higher, defeat the beast at the top of the mountain and claim its soul. Oh, but make sure you're well prepared before you head onwards. Remember, you're welcome here anytime you like. We all abandoned our assignments, which means our life now ticks away. However, we are happier for it. This is the way it should be. Without death, new life cannot grow. Greetings, foretold crow. This is the gate of knowledge. Its eyes see all things. Its heart knows all things. And its soul exists in all things. It whispers to us when we need guidance. It foretold your arrival and your destiny. The foretold crow, it is an honor to meet you. Did you find any of our shrines on your journey? It seems there are still 4 shrines you have yet to find. I am sure they will help you on your journey and in the fight with the beast atop the mountain. Welcome, foretold crow. We live a simple life here, foraging and living off the land. We even use fur shed by the beast atop of the mountain as bedding. This way to the frozen canyon. Exercise caution. Slippery. Phew. It's quite a steep climb getting up here. My pipes are wheezing. You must be pleased this punch, though, huh? I mean, a secret crow society up here on the mountains? Who knew? And they have so many great stories about their lives up here, especially about the beast atop the mountain. Yeah, I am getting so much inspiration on our adventure. I think my next song might be the greatest I've ever written. And I've written more than 5. This way to the beast lair, via the old watchtowers. You found a shiny medallion. You're a real winner. This medallion belongs to the Free Crows, a breakaway faction of Reapers who have chosen to quit their jobs and live a natural life. These crows sometimes adorn themselves with medallions such as this one, which depicts the ancient god who they believe prophesies the fall of the Lord of Dolls. Dang, the weather sure is rough up here. The wind's just howling through my pipes. Still, a bit of bad weather has never deterred me before, especially with the beast so close now. I wonder what it looks like. Based on what the crows said, it sounds like a proper monster. All hairy and wild. I can't wait to see you fight it. This is it. That's the beast. Oh boy, my heart is pounding. Are you gonna fight it? I'm gonna stay well out of the way and, take notes for my song. Good luck. Benny. Ouch. Yeah, no time for three attacks. Ow. Very difficult to dodge her roll. Okay. We gather here today to mourn the passing of Betty. To some, she was revered as a god. To others, feared as a wild, untamable beast. And to a small few, loved as a radiant beauty. After many lifetimes lived atop the mountain, supplying locals with fur and ultimately deaths, she can now rest. Bow your head in remembrance. Pay your last respects. Her time in this world is over. Another demonic soul's anger quelled, Reaper. May they find peace in death. What an incredible adventure this has been, full of twists and turns. So Betty and the beast were one and the same. Amazing. That means the drunken guy the stranded sailor was he in love with the beast? Whoa. I kind of feel bad for them both now. Dead or heartbroken, which do you think is worse? They're both kind of tragic. Still, it's great material for a song, huh? I'm gonna start writing straight away. Once it's ready, come by the Stranded Sailor sometime, and I'll play it for you. Hey there, matey. Thanks again for the adventure. I've never seen anything like it before. And I got enough material to make what I think could be my magnum opus. Wanna hear it? Alright, here we go. The drunk crow did love a lass named Betty. But it turned out she was a big hairy yeti. The hero and the beast battled till they both got all sweaty. But Betty the Yeti got sliced into spaghetti. And now she'll never see that wedding confetti. Very nice, although could have sung that somewhere else. I am so sorry. It had to be done.